Hi there, Eric Bakker, New Zealand naturopath. Thanks for coming back and looking at my video. Right, another SIBO one here. Why diet alone is not enough to treat SIBO. I just did a SIBO video before, in fact, regarding a question I had from a lady about why is SIBO so hard to treat. So remember, SIBO is a small intestinal bowel overgrowth problem. And many people who've got this problem may be on a FODMAP diet, or a low carbohydrate kind of diet. You know, there are different kind of diets. FODMAPs is quite a well-known diet. So, but is this FODMAPs diet really helping to get rid of SIBO, or is it just treating the symptoms of SIBO? Well, if you start looking at a FODMAPs diet, low carbohydrate, and take these foods out of the equation, you're taking away the carbohydrate-rich foods, which build the symptoms up and create the gas and the bloating and the pain. So if you look at these particular carbohydrate foods, when we move them out, we do get a reduction in symptoms, especially the pain, the bloating, and the gas, right? And these are the hydrogen producing bacteria, but also the constipation often improves because of the methane producing bacteria. We're reducing them, but it's actually quite a silly thing to do long term, is to take all these foods out of the diet, because what we're in fact doing is we're potentially starving the bacteria further down in the gut and creating more problems, you know, than we should. We're going to end up with often low lactobacillus levels and low levels of bifidobacteria. I've repeatedly seen this on stool tests on people who've been on FODMAPs diets or low carb diets for, you know, several months or years. They end up with very low levels of beneficial bacteria. And then they end up with fatigue and a lot of deficiencies, tiredness, brain fog, many problems. And they can't understand why they're getting these symptoms on a FODMAPs diet when they should be feeling better. Well, I believe this is symptomatic treatment. I don't really like it. It's very important to bring an antimicrobial in. As soon as you start noticing changes, when the symptoms start going down, even at the beginning, the first few weeks after a FODMAPs diet, you should be putting an antimicrobial in straight away. Okay, it's very important to do that, because you want to actually kill and reduce some of these bacteria, not just starve them, but actually eradicate them and allow the beneficial bacteria to come up at the same time you're killing these bad ones. Not allow a starvation to occur of the beneficial bacteria. It's a very intelligent approach and it works well. My experience of thousands of patients has shown me that diets for SIBO long-term don't work unless they're really used in conjunction with a good antimicrobial and a good probiotic and a good enzyme. That's when they work very, very well. I've helped many people get back to health with SIBO by doing exactly this approach, right? So diet alone is no good. Using a combination therapy of multiple antimicrobials, a bit of oregano oil here, a bit of garlic here, a bit of grapefruit seed here, a little bit of, you know, this or that. It's expensive and it's very cumbersome and it's difficult to manage. Same thing with taking antibiotics like rifaximin. Rifaximin alone will do not much for the majority of people. Over half the people I see who take rifaximin don't get the outcome they're looking for. Using a natural antimicrobial at the beginning and using it all the way through for several months is going to give you a much better outcome, because you're not going to wipe out those good bugs. You're going to allow them to stay there, which is going to boost your immune health up significantly and your overall health and allow you to more quickly counter this condition, right? Check out CanXida Remove and CanXida Restore. They've worked for many people with SIBO and they should be able to work for you as well. It's a simple protocol. I've done many videos on SIBO you can go and have a look at. I've also done several videos on the CanXida products you can check out as well. But I can speak from experience that it's helped many people, and especially people who are dissatisfied with conventional treatment using rifaximin and other kinds of drugs like that. So just remember, SIBO doesn't respond really well to diet alone. At some stage you'll need to use an antimicrobial and also a good probiotic and an enzyme formula to help really get that gut working to a high level. So I hope that's a bit of useful information for you. Don't forget to click on the link below in the description box if you want my CanXida report. Thanks for tuning in.